Okay, 3 p.m. I think we start with Senator Janowski from CASA. And you can work.
Hello, my name is Alexander Janowski, yes, and I'm CEO and CEO at GPS Technologies. And we have GPS double is open source in application delivery controller. And also we took custom software development and high performance energy participation and the database. Another example would be a web application firewall mentioned by Gartner Magic Quadrant, the medical architecture of the product. And also, right now we have a new feature for MariaDB, MariaDB, so MariaDB AD. And the feature will be hopefully in May 3, in MariaDB 7.3. Right now you can fetch actual version of the feature from our repository at GitHub. So we started GPS Double by request of one of our customers. It was a huge web hosting provider. They actually wanted to protect huge web hosting against very complicated DDoS attacks. And especially they were interested about application-related DDoS attacks as the most complicated attacks to detect and prevent. And we started to from fetching engineers from trying other open source web integrators, and we quickly realized that modern web integrators are suitable for our tasks. So we had a look at kernel accelerators. They behave a bit better, however, they also didn't satisfy our needs. We realized that we need some kind of hybrid of a web accelerator and a firewall to be able to process HTTP as fast as possible and generate complex tools to work application-aware attacks. So it must have very fast HTTP accelerator because we still need to process HTTP requests to fight against HTTP views and other DDoS attacks. It must have a very fast web cache to be able to mitigate DDoS attacks if we cannot find out all and work all the bots. Also, we need very strong network set to be able to fight against attacks with many concurrent connections, short-lived HTTP connections, and so on. Also, advanced fitting, I also mentioned the probability. So we started from hybrid of a web accelerator and a firewall. We were there and we moved to kernel space. During this presentation, I will put a lot of details about current problems with user space web accelerators and explain in details why we move to kernel space. So basically, first, the type of GPS was just a web accelerator, a firewall, and since usually web accelerators stay in front of huge server farms, we implemented several web balancing algorithms. As our development moved forward, we implemented more load balancing capabilities. We introduced several few logic to protect against web application attacks. And we also need to use SSL and implement it in kernel space because nowadays an internet application works using HTTPS. Data compression and connection score to survive is still in progress. Basically, software and such products are named like application delivery controllers. And typically, you find the mix of the functions. open source has equal solution, equal in performance to these proprietary boxes, and such is fully open source. Typical examples of TKSLDAO would be the same exactly as for any application here at Oracle. So if you think about more performance and protection, for example, if it's not enough performance from Nginx or other web accelerator, then you might think about hardware box, for example, from 5. To put it in front of your Nginx or Vanish file and protect and create a content. And typically, this use case is also used for TKSLDAO. It can be used in massive CDNs, content management systems, shared hosting, and so on, a lot of use cases. So, we started to discover what's wrong with nowadays web accelerator architecture. So the first thing which we did is to put some DDoS root on Nginx. And surprisingly, we found that Nginx spends a bit more time to work malicious requests rather than survive it from static file. Basically, it uses very small static file. And surely you will see different picture if you use large dynamic content and have dynamic code. But anyway, we think it's unacceptable to spend a lot of resources to work malicious traffic because we have just a lot of requests from those codes. The problem with Nginx is it's very limiting model. Basically, when you need to survive such content and block malicious requests, you do exactly the same logic. You must still send error response to new malicious file which you just observed. However, you must run additional logic which is implemented in rate limiting model. So the limiting functionality in Nginx introduces additional logic and additional complexity which takes this one extra microsecond. So to cope with the issues, people usually configure Nginx not to send error response to different clients. And sometimes they use some log passes like page 1 to process Nginx access walks and generate in runtime repeatable rules. However, the technology based on passing and writing text file looks like 50 years old. It's not fast, and sometimes people recommend to just switch off access walks for better performance. So, it seems I have issues with slides. One might think about writing a Nginx model which will generate rules, IP table rules on the fly. However, generate coupling web accelerator with a firewall is not the whole story. And actually, we have a lot of issues with web accelerators. Actually, any modern web accelerators were designed to deliver content in normal circumstances. So in most cases, they deliver perfect performance for you. And most of the cases means that your clients are innocent, good clients. However, web accelerators like Nginx provide some features, and we just saw that fishing is not so fast. It's a true thing to defer application where it does text. And also, all the servers are basically designed in early 2000s, when we had an issue to handle 10,000 connections concurrently. It's not a problem to generate 10,000 or 100,000 connections for DDoS botnet. And actually, DDoS is always about corner cases. It means that if your system has a bottleneck, for example, establish a SSH connection, then an attacker can generate exactly an attack against your SSH handshake. If you're not so fast to handle small packets, then attacker can generate flows with a lot of small packets. So it was always about corner cases. And we started in our project to be reliable and stable against the corner cases. So we can deliver stable performance regardless of normal flash calls, the audience, and the DDoS attack. So as we analyze it, kernel mode web activators behaves a bit better because there's no context switches and so on. So however, modern systems, modern operating systems, and modern CPU architectures provide very nice features like TLPOPI and LazyTLP, which makes context switch very cheap. And kernel accelerators nowadays. However, I will show that if we think about hardware solution which can defend against DDoS and deliver stable performance for normal operation, we still need kernel access. One of the huge problems which is now addressed by Facebook, Ashhead, and Netflix is TLS. Basically, if you need to send your content to encrypted connection, you must to copy the file content to user space, and after that, you encrypt it and copy again to transmit the content to the encrypted socket. So, the guys tried to move only encryption part of TLS to kernel. So now we can use the serial interface to send file and send the encrypted content without copy. However, TLS and shape remains in user space and it's vulnerable for DDoS attack in shape. So this is why we move it to TLS into the kernel. If we think whether we can take one web server, modern web server, and optimize it and develop further such that it will deliver more performance and will be capable to defend against large DDoS attacks. That is not. We this trace for trace profile for Nginx and simple HTTP boot attack. And we see that the most hotspot is HTTP parser. We also have some copying and network IO routiness. And finally, this late living logic takes also the good place. This is top 10 of most hot calls. And we see that the file is actually flat. It means that there is no single point of which you can optimize and increase performance of the server in two times, for example, or in three times. It means that if we need to make a solution, for example, three times faster, we need to develop the core architecture, we need to remove the slow I/O, we need to remove copying and so on. The problem with user space accelerators are also system calls. They should be cheap in nowadays system calls. They still not for free. Typical request handling takes about 9 system calls in Nginx, and we can eliminate only one of them if we disable access lock. By the way, so far I'm talking about Nginx. However, most of the things which I say are also applicable to other web accelerators. And this is just an example which we started for. The other problem is web cache. A lot of web accelerators still use old-fashioned partition-based databases, some kind of databases. because they generate keys in the database using hash on URI and host header. And the funny part begins at you see that there are short directory names, and we have a hierarchy of two layers. And the things are done to cope with slow file system operation. Actually, to find a file in file system having thousands of files is extremely slow operation. File open system calls extremely slow because requires network hub and requires disk access. So Nginx uses cache of open file descriptors and should use a cache to debate the problem. However, it's not about stable performance. So you can easily get DDoS attack which will just iterate over all your available resources. So your cache will be efficiently created and you will run without cache and you use the plain file system on each request. That's a simple case how we can kill such web servers. So Apache Docker server starts to do more clever things and they implemented some kind of database to handle web cache. So we do the same. Also, this variant HTTP header, which actually requires a secondary key in terms of additional databases. The problem is, if you have some content, which can be delivered, which can have different versions, for example, for mobile ones at the bottom and desktop ones at the top, and you want to send different content to different devices. Content has the same URI and host, so it stored in the same file, in the same file system. And you need some kind of secondary key to differentiate web users from desktop users. So you use the secondary key, and if where is this file's user agent, then you can take care about user agent value and generate different content for secondary key. So all in all, we need a real database to efficiently handle web content with stable performance results. The next thing is HTTP parser. As we just saw, HTTP parser is a hotspot in under DDoS root. And surprisingly, most of HTTP servers use old-fashioned dummy approach to process HTTP. This example of parser state machine. So we have a while loop with a switch statement, and now we have a state variable with value. Again, we have value 1, we have the state 1, and we have input chapter B. So we start from checking state variable. We move to proper state with corresponding to proper chapter, and we assign new value to state variable. Next, we move to end of while and switch statement. Keep in mind that at this point we catch at least three cache lines of code cache. The first cache line we fetched at the beginning of while and case statement. The second line we fetched at processing case B when we assigned value to the state variable. And the third line is fetched right now at the end of the loop and switch statement. Now we move to begin of the loop. We start to check state variable again. And finally, we go to state 2. If we look at the picture and try to understand what's happening, we see just a lot of spinning around the code. Reason, at state 1 and given chapter B as input, we know precisely where we need to go. In this case, we can just fetch the next instruction. We don't need any jump at all. So our CPU prefer to work perfectly. If you would be in state 1 and case A, we need to jump, but we again know exactly where we need to be. We do not need the dummy state variable. We don't handle it, and we can save a lot of logic. This parser is actually generated by Railjet code generator. And we do apply the same logic in our parser, and we also split set of states in different pieces to generate a slow switch jump table as possible. So we apply different optimization strategy to make the jumps and processing as fast as possible. Well, HTTP is actually a text protocol. This is version 1.1. So you can easily get very large streams. It could be a cookie. We saw in the agent about 65 kilobytes in size. It could be cookies, URIs, in the agent. So sometimes you need to process very long streams. Sometimes we have a mix to HTTP extension for about 3 years. HTTP still doesn't use the extension in their recuperations. Moreover, HTTP streams is a very special case. There are different points which makes HTTP streams special, and they are all important in optimization of stream processing in HTTP case. The first one is that actually we do not need to treat 0 byte in a special way. Actually, we have several binary holes in ASCII, and we should treat 0 byte the same way. Secondly, there are special derivatives, and CRLF makes a real trouble for us. Because if we upgrade in zero copy fashion, CRLF will be in one packet, LLF will be in other packet, and we have to keep function state machine states between the receiving the path of the derivative. Also, some basic wires sends just LLF as one terminated in DAOs, we have to handle the terminator the same way. In HTTP path, when you put your own HTTP path, you definitely have some such streams. For example, it could be names of HTTP headers which you want to process in a special way. For example, host header, user agent header, cookie header, and so on. So these names are encoded in HTTP path directory. So you have constant streams. So when you compare input stream against this constant stream, you don't need to convert case of the second stream. You need actually only one case conversion for input stream only, and you can save necessary iterations. And in the same case, CMP converts streams of both cases of both of the streams. If you need to validate input string against the word alphabet, you might think about using str spear to accept or reject some alphabets. And this is a bad idea because str spear spends just incredibly many resources to compile, accept, or reject sets. Basically, HTTP has only several word alphabets for different HTTP headers and URI, and you can encode the sets directly in your HTTP parser. In some of modern HTTP servers, there are attempts to do strings processing like matching HTTP header names using file set machine, as we just saw previous slide. And the performance of such passes are very, very slow. The last thing about modern web accelerators is network I/O. Actually, we can consider an example on the slide. There are three packets, and left each packet contains four HTTP messages. So, firstly, we need the packets in software queue, and software queue places the packet in input queue of sockets. After that, software queue wakes up process owning the socket, and process starts to copy the data from kernel to user space, process HTTP, and do some other order. When process finishes with the first socket, it can find the packets on the second socket already out of the cache. DCA technology, DD cache technology from Intel shines in this situation. However, DCA places network packets in web 3 of CPU cache. However, if you want to process 10 gigabits network traffic, where the cache will be not enough to wait while user space process pass HTTP, copy data, and so on. So in Tempesta, we typically built in HTTP parser into HTTP IPsec, and all the packets are processed as soon as possible, while all the data in CPU cache. All the issues which I just mentioned are listed in Tempesta Doubleware, and this is a hybrid of HTTP IPsec and the firewall. Actually, it's motivated firewall because it uses firewall rules and IPware and HTTPware. It's built in HTTP IPsec, and we ship built-in filters to fight against web server DDoS and web application attacks. As I told, we employ faster HTTP parser. We have a specially designated in-memory database, which is malware and hardly optimized for modern hardware. Have advanced load balancing schedules, and I will cover the topics in the next slide. I want to start from benchmarks. Benchmark results and description. How do we do the benchmark such that you can reproduce the results? You can find them in our wiki. And the slide shows that we can reach 1.8 million requests per second on 4 cores CPU. It's one of the cheapest CPU. If we analyze the performance result carefully, basically this is somewhat 3 times faster than web chip engineering can reach on the same CPU. We should be much more faster than the DDoS condition because we have that integrated firewall. We can work quite more faster than any engineering processing while using very limited failure 1 and so on. However, it's basically very difficult to produce DDoS workloads. I mean, it's very difficult to emulate DDoS workload in test labs. For example, we have about 3 servers now that are bad, and real DDoS is not possible to emulate in this environment. The next interesting result is about popular user space HTTP servers. And one of the examples of web HTTP servers implemented on top of user space accelerators is SealStar. Basically, it's not so clear for me from their performance benchmark whether they whether the 1.3 million requests per second for 4 cores or 4 hybrid threads. But either way, CSR beat slower or beat faster than Tempesta Doubleware. So basically, we are comparable in performance for normal GPU process with good user space CIP stacks. However, we do not have dual web or such approaches because GPS is actually Linux. It's built into Linux kernel. It's probably we can argue about this approach, probably is not so good. However, we fully integrated with any Linux utilities. For example, if you need to write some IP table rules and the graphic which is passed to GPS double will be fitted by IP tables. Go ahead and do that. If you need to run speed up and analyze graphic processed by GPS, you can do that. You can use graphic control to distribute graphic to control graphic which is passing through GPS and so on. So basically if you need to do such things in user space step itself, you either must re-implement them for user space step or you need to use some dummy interfaces with swapping and additional overheads. So our approach is yes, we know that going based system is not good, but we argue to not to copy code twice. It's not good for based system one to execute two copies of CPI steps on the same system. If you need to go further, then you need to run two firewalls to the same system. You need to run two individual server and whatever. Just do not copy and redo device the code when divided by smart HTTP developers. Also, I want to mention that while there are a lot of HTTP steps implemented in user space, you can imagine how large speed step is. And basically, a lot of user space speed steps don't have good extensions like selective acknowledgements, different speed congestion control values, and so on. So actually, the speed step of Linux is good and fast, and we can employ it, and we can make use it. Let's have a look at GPS architecture. So if we have a packet going to network adapter, we check it against our rules, and we have the next, we process it in HTTP parser and run analyzing model text ways and analyze already passed HTTP request and apply HTTP rules against it. If it decides that the request is malicious, it will generate new rule which will be put to web theme and we will just block the request. If the request is good, then we can pass it to upstream or to pass to our cache. As I said, we use common circuits. Since we live in Linux kernel, we do not use file descriptors, we do not use input queues, and so on. So there are no walls. However, the case why user space HTTP accelerators are small, while we still see very good numbers for user space HTTP, is that real world HTTP server must solve different issues. One of the issues is blocking HTTP requests. In this example, we have two sockets. First one is client, the second one is server socket. We have two CPUs. And basically, if you have a bidirectional connection between client and server, client sends new requests, like using HTTP by client and server, it wants various requests. Then you might want to take log of HTTP control blocks in different order and you easily can go to that log. This hard thing will still need to solve it using user space HTTP step. And in our project we use in the CPU interconnection transport. We use in buttons per CPU. And if we consider graphic from 1 to 7, First, the package. It's protested on first PU TP.org. Now we have no working because all TP.orgs are bidded to work with TPU. So Fabric TPU cannot access to work all server. So first we process the incoming package to on the first TP.org. Next we voice request to need buffer of server socket. And CPU, which handles socket, will do actual transfer to server. So there's no working. We have great performance on index traffic and low latency for web. So also we were very good with unit low latency HPC wise. We did a preliminary performance measurements in 2015 of synchronous circuits. We see that the blue line of synchronous circuits much faster establish new connection in comparison with user space circuits and other camera space circuits. Also, we have more stable and more performance in processing HTTP. Packets also compared with our other kernel circuits. I already said about HTTP processing. You can find algorithms about HTTP parser and particular things processing in our work. And not just a few numbers. We bit faster than Nginx in 1.6-1.8 times in short HTTP requests. However, if you go to long strings, for example, with reaction or URI, it's something about 1 kilobyte, it's not so reaction, not so reaction URI. The URI cookies of such things is very common nowadays. And our string processing can be faster in 3 or 6 times the VT and user space implementations. We also use dedicated web cache. It's basically on top of NumaWare architecture. We work with NumaWare means that we can copy data on new monodes to be able to survive requests from local monode, or we can do sharding computing which not will respond. And we use our own unique algorithms that is captured to for faster index in the database. Basically, it's based on modern research cache caches data searches. And the core idea of the data search is that we have an array of very short offsets in one CPU cache wire. So we have 16 cache wires. If you want to find some string, we calculate cache value, and we use less significant 4 bits. Since now we have more data, we just allocate new data page and place data in it. If we find that our data page is full, we have a lot of collisions, then we pass the node. During the pass, we allocate new index node, which is always the second 4 bits, and we have to split our data page. And this is the only place we use locks. Any other places, operations with data search are lock free. So basically, TPS provides several limiting functionality for DDoS attacks. You can also defer against all HTTP attacks, specifying time limits and chunk numbers. It's basically very hard to do in user space because you do not control the network pages. Also, you have a protection against several web attacks, for example, HTTP response split. We account carefully HTTP requests and responses. Basically, we possibly go in our set of feeding water. However, we do only very fast water. If we feel that we need to do some complex water, for example, to process XML in response to something like that, we leave the water for user space web application files. So the point of TPS is just to learn very fast water and we can analyze the traffic. We have also what viruses. I would say probably some of them are known. For example, the Tezos hashing is stable to fail over. We use machine learning technology in forecasting and predictive schedule. We analyze how quickly server requires to request and build trends against it. I would skip example configuration. We have a sticky cookies to fight against DDoS, which are unable to solve cookie challenges and provide sticky session precision scheduling. Prerequisites are clear because we use modern CPU features. Finally, I just want to address some of questions and concerns about the code. Firstly, TPS is a very small piece of code. It's much smaller than any modern FileCC. We do not try to move any water from HPX directly to the kernel. Moreover, we are going to deliver fast transfer to user space of parsed HTTP messages. And the TPS will deliver a web application firewall which is more capable with extended functionality in user space. We use best practices in Linux kernel development. You can find our pull requests and what we use at our GitHub. We will deliver packages so you not need to build kernel and TPS by hand. So as a result, as conclusion, TPS is always very good if you need a lot of performance when traditional TPS servers are not enough for you and when you need to defend efficiently against various DDoS attacks. So thank you. Our site is powered by TPS Double for 9 months. We didn't see any failure during the time. Availability is at our GitHub. Any contribution are very welcome. And you can find algorithms and so on at our blog. So thank you for listening. Just a few minutes for questions.
Do we have questions, please?
No questions.
No one from the audience. So this is available and compilable to the kernel.
Or
your code is available, I see, and it's compilable to the actual kernel version.
Yes.
What you see is your site is powered by your own product, obviously.
We have a patch in for the kernel. You can download it from our GitHub, and we have a kernel model. So it's not a Linux mainstream so far. Probably we will be in the mainstream some time future, but not now. Did I answer your question?
Yeah, thank you. Some more, if not. No questions anymore. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you
for having me here. It was very interesting. Maybe a pause. One more.
Thank you.